Welcome back to the Six on Your Side Hot Seat. The topic, the apparent turmoil surrounding the Inspector General's office in New Orleans. Again, joining us tonight, Nolan Rollins, CEO of the Urban League of Greater New Orleans, and Dr. Michael Cowan of Loyola University. Again, gentlemen, thank you for being here. No doubt both of you are interested in salvaging the Inspector General's office, but what effect is the absence of the newly hired IG, Edward Quatrevo, exacerbating the situation? Let's begin with you, Mr. Rollins.
You know, I think that there's always going to have to be a transition period where folks have to get things ramped down or ramped down in another position and ramped up in a new position. But I think it's an inopportune time. I mean, I think we're in a very tough situation and a tough time right now. And I think when the community is crying out for leadership, that having this gap, which would be a normal gap in any other instance, it makes it even tougher because the questions that the community actually has, they need answers, and they need answers in a way that's actually clear. And though it may be something that's normal in the normal course of every day, I think that we're in a situation right now where it makes it a bit tougher.
So, Dr. Cowan, who's going to write this ship?
Norman, the acting Inspector General David Westerling is a person that I've worked with over the past year. He's a man of competence and integrity, and I feel very comfortable with him at the helm. And I also think the Ethics Review Board is continuing to pay close attention and work with this as they have all along.
Now, Dr. Kevin Wiles, Chairman, you just talked about the Ethics Review Board. He's chairman of that board. He was publicly critical of the former Interim Inspector General Odom. In fact, glad to see him go. Couldn't wait to get rid of him as soon as they hired the new Inspector General. To what degree is he now part of the problem, Mr. Rollins?
You know, I think that that's probably something that he shouldn't have said. I think that this is a process by which things should be handled carefully, and I think that in leadership roles we often have to be careful of how we actually say the things that we're saying, because the public actually picks up on those things. So, you know, while there may be it may be important for him to have closed the chapter of one book to open up another, I think that making that type of statement actually wasn't helpful in the transition and helpful in the public eye.
How do you see it, Dr. Cowan? Is he part of the problem now?
I see it in the same way that Nolan just mentioned, Norman. And I think if you ask Father Wilds directly, he would acknowledge that, regretting that comment as well.
How does he make amends?
Well, I don't know if he wants to make amends or needs to for that specific comment, but I think what he needs to do is what he is doing and what he has been doing for a long time now, and that's carrying a terrific burden of getting this office established from nothing, really.
What do you think about the NAACP now calling for an investigation of the IG's office by the Ethics Review Board?
You know, I mean, I think that this is a question of process. I mean, this is a question of how did we get from where we were to where we are now, and if there are questions about what does the process actually look like, I mean, these are the things that the community is actually going to be asking. These are the questions that are going to be out there. I mean, I think what we should always want is that if we're going to have an outcome that's going to be transparent, the process by which we get to that transparency has to be transparent also. So I think that that's what the cry is for, and I think that there can be proactive things done to really get out in front of this and say, this is how these things actually happen, here's where we are, this is how we're going to move forward. So, you know, I think they're within their right to make that case.
What's going to have to be done now, Dr. Collins, to actually salvage the Inspector General's position and the position of the police monitor?
Norman, with all due respect, I think salvage is the wrong word here. I think it's too dramatic and too negative, too intense a word. We've got a difficulty that needs to be dealt with. I believe that the critical thing is that the new Inspector General come in, shine a bright light on whatever it is that happened before he got here, and I believe that he'll do that.
So you think that the word salvage should not be used in context with this particular controversy?
I think it paints the situation a lot more negatively than it needs to be painted.
You're hearing voices from the public now who are saying, this is New Orleans. Does anything go right here? Even the Inspector General's office is having problems. That doesn't pose a serious problem for you in the context of how people are perceiving this
I don't dis- I'm sorry I don't dismiss that feeling for a moment, but I do want to say this. As far as I can tell, New Orleans has been mired in waste and corruption and patronage since it became a city. the players have changed, but the process seems to remain the same. I don't know why. I think we shouldn't be surprised that it's going to take some time and that there are going to be some serious bumps in going after waste and fraud and abuse in city government, and I think that's what we're having.
All right, we'll find out if this is a serious bump or an implosion down the line. Yes, Dr. Cowan, Mr. Rollins, thanks for being our guest.
Thank you.